Welcome to Contractually Obligated, the game show where we take a look at a bunch of games that game devs are nice enough to give me. The way this works is I never actually look at the game ahead of time. I just hit play on the game with you, and we see what's going to happen. First up today is a game called Nightbook. It just looks spooky already. Viewer discretion is advised. We've got double mouse action going. Yeah, this is interesting. What the hell was that? This is pretty sweet. Send me an email, quick. Dad's slipping.
Get away from me.
Drug him. Calm down.
Get up!
Alright, so we got an achievement for drugging him. Some butterfly effect thing came up.
Get up! No.
I guess it's gonna leave a long-term impact.
No.
Dad's too loud, I had to turn it back down. This is kind of like Night. I'm gonna say it's like Night Trap. Which is an old ass.
Don't come in.
Dad, it's me. I got your dinner.
Sega CD.
No.
Thriller, we'll call it.
You said curry was your favorite since your.
Tracker. Alright, we're still good with Dad. Drug him is probably not gonna make him very happy.
For a bit. I want you to be happy.
And since this is definitely one of those games that are like one-time playthrough only kind of deal, at least for the story, I'm not going to do too much of this then. But this is full motion and awesome.
Now, quickly.
She don't got no time for this, she's pregnant. Alright, we got some stuff to go on here. This is interesting. I wish it was a little more interactive. Like, at least let me click on the things to get the stuff going forward. But it's not horrible. Spamming them emojis. Leave them on red, or whatever the hell it's called. What's the thing that people do to get people mad about? Getting left on red? Giving them much more time here.
What?
See, like, let me do those things. That's what I'm saying. We're getting hacked. It's not supposed to be. I don't know. Oh, it's supposed to be. Okay. He's crazy overprotective husband. That's why he knows what dad's doing, too.
You look perfect. How depressing.
Good evening, Cody. Ready when you are.
You start. I'm just going to turn my camera off for a sec.
I can't turn it off. What's going on?
God's Hand Archipelago boasts some of the most beautiful sites in the North Pacific Ocean.
Certains des plus beaux sites de l'océan Pacifique Nord.
This is perhaps, she's very good.
None more so than its largest island, Nepos. However, despite this, there is very little development on the island, and no tourism.
Très sauvage et n'accueille que peu de touristes.
The Neem Bateau Hotel Group, in conjunction with Quinton Engineering, is proposing the development of the Iowa Well Cove site into a luxury 35-room hotel, spa, and scuba diving complex.
We're not going to cheat. You crazy?
Et des services de plongée avec masque et scaphandre.
Our consultation period has already begun, and we know that you will be as committed as we are to bringing this project to fruition with the minimum disruption to the natural landscape and wildlife of this beautiful
bay.
Our preliminary planning application is before the God's Hand Island Council, and we hope that you will join us in making our proposition the best it can be for the local economy and employment prospects so that construction can begin early next year, ready to open our doors the following year.
Et une promesse de création d'emplois pour que les travaux puissent commencer au début de l'année prochaine. Et que ce nouveau complexe...
It's kind of hard to tell what this is setting up for this game.
To,
like, I'll assume the indoor security cameras are the bad thing.
Nous sommes une compagnie tournée vers le futur et nous espérons vous servir dans un futur proche.
It's kind of hard to tell. Something with the baby. Her husband's probably crazy. Her almost husband. Her dad's losing it.
Right. Let's have a little look then, shall we?
Cody's
well, I forgot the
in.
Word for scuba diving and...
Yeah, because that's a word you hear every day.
I tried to keep up the pace, but I wasn't fast enough.
He was talking really fast. Look, there was a golden half second there where I really thought you had it. You were getting the gist across, nice, simple, and quick. And then you went straight back to trying to get it exactly right.
Can we do another one?
What? No.
Please, your advice is so valuable to me. I know I can do better.
You know what I think? I think you should cut yourself a break. This is interpreting, not translation. You don't have to be word fucking perfect.
Hell yeah.
There isn't...
Uh-oh. Glitch in the Matrix.
There isn't time. Speaking of which... What was that?
Nothing.
It's my dad hawking out.
Okay, give me 15 minutes to clear some emails, then let's get this shift started.
And on that note, we're going to stop because it's start picking up. But that's a nightbook that definitely, I assumed from like the beginning image, that was just be like one of those weird, stupid kind of full motion video kind of games. But that one actually seems really, really neat. It seems like it has a lot of potential. So that I actually might go back to at some point, to be honest with you. Up next is Planet Zoo, a game that's been out forever, but I recently got the Arctic Pack. I never actually had the game until I got the Arctic Pack. So I think what I'm going to do here is we're going to play Planet Zoo for a little bit, and I think I'm going to use this to leverage it into a full playthrough of Planet Zoo. So if you're interested in seeing what kind of zoo stuff I can do down the road, tune in to TobesPlays.com right here on YouTube, and we will keep it going. But as for the contractually obligated part of this game show, we're just going to check it out for a little bit here.
Hey-o.
Most important part, where is there is no bald people. That's... Oh, I freaking hate when games do that. So I'm doing old school. Wait, this is your face. Okay. What kind of face do I have? Probably a small one. What does that do? Well, I might as well look like myself back in the day. When I was a young Toby and had the swoopy hair and hid underneath giant baggy hats like that. Gotta make this look nice, everybody. Can I not change the undershirt? No. Okay. Close enough. We don't need a stupid hat for now. It's okay. Yeah. And let's see. This is where your HQ will be. We might as well start at home-ish. Alright, the Goodwin House. Renovated, and renamed after its purchase. One of the more respectable zoos. Has some incidents we have to take care of, though. At this point, too, I think I have two or three different packs. Two different, like, animal packs. I just don't know when those will come up. So hopefully I play this enough just to see. This place looks awesome.
Ah, heyo ad hematu.
Oh, don't speak Planko to me. This looks like a really fucking fancy zoo.
Slipping back into the Planko language. It's good to finally meet you in person. I'm Bernard, although I insist you call me Bernie. The only person who calls me Bernard is my wife. And even then,
never track elephant poop on the carpets. Come on.
As you know, I own several zoos, but I always like to show people the ropes here at my home. This is the first zoo I ever opened, and a source of great pride for me.
Got some bootleg Slurpees.
Thanks to a lion breeding program.
Chief Beef? That's everybody's favorite.
But we're in the middle of a big renovation.
Alright, stop talking now.
You come in. Sadly, our old contractor had to retire after developing a fur allergy. Poor devil kept sneezing his dentures into the lion habitat. So, it's up to you to finish everything off. Don't worry, though. I'm not completely throwing you in at the deep end. My head keeper, Nancy Jones, will be lending a helping hand. Oh, she's a hard worker. And she'll expect you to be, too. But I'm sure you'll get along like
too much speaking.
Even better, one that isn't on fire. Less shouting that way.
Let me just fix the damn lines. Come on.
Hello there. From that rosy, fresh face of yours, I'm guessing you're Bernie's new hire. Good. Now, I hope you're ready to ditch your diploma because we're about to get really hands-on. But before we begin the real work, how about we familiarize you with the zoo by learning how to fly around it and visiting some of our beautiful animals? We'll start by popping over.
There's a crazy mouth thing on this right now. Grizzly bears. All right, grizzly bears. They're down here.
Did you know that grizzly bears, also known as Ursus arctos
horribilis,
can hibernate for up to 7 months a year? Oh, but then again, given the chance, I think a lot of people would do that too. Select one of the bears and you'll bring up its information panel.
No, get back in, Fatso. Get back in. No. Yeah, look at the little buddy go.
This is where you can find out all kinds of information about your animal. The most important thing being its overall welfare. You'll learn more about animal welfare today as we go through your objectives.
Look at him go.
But for now, let's enjoy this magnificent animal. Why don't you select the camera at the bottom of its information panel?
I looked at his camera.
See now, this is a fantastic way to get a
close look at your
animals. You can also
orbit.
Get this view
okay.
of an animal by simply double-clicking on it. Oh, Okay, when you're ready, let's pop over to the other side of the
zoo and
take
a
look at the lions. I've marked their location for you
here.
To find.
You guys lions? You guys cool?
Panthera Leo Leo, all the West African lion to you and me. Lions are the most social of the big cats.
You're gonna jack these people up.
40 lions in a pride.
I fucking hate balloons.
That size are pretty rare. As Bernie would say, those lions are awesome, which is precisely why I handle the training instead these days. Anyway, how about we get started on those objectives? Come on, let's head over to an empty habitat and see what needs doing there.
All right, let's get crack in here. Like, is this not empty?
As you can see, it's a lovely space for animals.
Adopt some warthogs.
Certain something. Well, two somethings. Warthogs. So I'd like you to adopt a pair of them. To adopt animals, we need to open the animal market, which is in the animal trading section. There we are.
Adopt, don't shop.
Perfectly splendid warthogs for our zoo.
Remember
that. Just click on them and select adopt from the side menu. Normally the
animal
exchange would be
full of storage,
animals, but I've emptied out the market.
Unlocks for doing things, all right.
The last thing I need is you accidentally ordering a dozen elephants. When you adopt an animal, it's automatically placed in the trade center, where they're held until you're ready to move them into their habitat, which, as it happens, you are. So how about you move them into their new home?
Would someone steal one of these already?
When you ask for an animal to be moved into a habitat, your caretakers will go to the trade center, collect your animal, and deliver them.
All right, let's
see them.
Drop these bad boys off here.
I've marked the trade center's location, so let's go and watch the caretakers in action.
Yeah, she says she marks these things off. I really don't feel like they are.
Well, as you can see, those caretakers don't hang about. They'll move those animals to their destination as fast as possible. Of course, normally we'd have
to place
the
animals
into quarantine before moving them into a habitat. But I am assured by a person of good standing that these warthogs are in
the
rudest of health. Right, let's get the warthog's habitat finished up so we can keep them nice and happy.
Got a warthog in a box because it dropped off here.
Each animal in the zoo has an overall welfare statistic, basically how happy they are. And that overall welfare statistic is itself comprised of four different areas.
Nutrition, it's a magic box.
Social health, habitat, and enrichment. Luckily, if you select an animal, you'll bring up the animal welfare information panel, which we saw earlier. Where you can see how they're doing. That way, you'll know exactly what areas need to be addressed. Don't worry if that's a lot to remember. You can always check the Zoopedia for more information. Let's start by making sure we're taking care of the warthog's nutrition welfare. To do this, we'll need to place a food station.
Oh, I think this is going a little slower than I thought it would be.
Each animal
requires
a different type.
I think we're gonna stop the tutorial a little bit early here. We're going to call it a day. So obviously there's lots of zooing to be done. And like I said, I'm probably going to start doing this as a main game on the channel. So if you do want to see the continuing quest of those warthogs, feel free to check it out. But if not, I think that's a we can call it an episode. Both the games today were pretty cool. Plant Zoo is definitely a long-term kind of play thing that I think I'm going to start. But thank you for watching as always. And I will see you next time for more contractually obligated fun. Lights.